Welcome to Real Food. What inspires you to cook? For me, I'm inspired by old family recipes and traditions, different cultures, and for my love of food. But one of the biggest cooking inspirations is chef, television host, author, restaurateur, and my very good friend, Lidia Bastianich. First, we're going to be preparing a carrot and orange salad, followed by spaghetti with anchovies and breadcrumbs. Well, here we are. Joining me is my friend Lidia Bastianich, my dear.
Ah, guess what? Pleasure being here again.
15th year you've come.
15 years.
Can you believe that?
My goodness.
We were both teenagers.
Time flies.
I know, isn't that great?
When you're having fun, they say.
And that's
say.
A lot of fun.
Yes.
And I tell you, everywhere I go, people love this show. And the show that they love the most is when you come and visit.
Well, thank you very much.
So,
but, you know, I love them. And I guess we love cooking together.
Well, together.
We love eating together.
That's true. And very similar in a lot of ways, right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
So, and you've been good? Everything's been good with you?
Yeah, fine. You know, had a great summer with the kids, back to school. Yeah.
And a new book coming?
A new book coming.
I'm excited about it. What book?
The Felidia. The Felidia, you know, the cookbook. It's 13.
Wow.
It's Felidia, you know, it's the restaurant in New York where I kind of became the chef. And so it's the recipes from the beginning, 1981,
oh,
we opened there, so that's been some time.
Wow.
And all the recipes from the beginning, the favorites of the restaurants, what people love, with a new chef now, Fortunato is the new chef there.
Sure.
So his recipe's mine, and I was very proud, very proud. And it's kind of an attestment to all the people that kind of work with me all these years.
Yeah, it's true. And that restaurant has wonderful, unique kind of styles of Italian food. I love that.
Yeah.
I mean, listen, I love Becco. You know I love Becco,
yes,
and that's close to my heart.
Yes.
But Felidia is a place where you can try different things sometimes.
Yeah, it's very regional. You know, Italy has so many regions. So the chef was born in Sicily, and he studied in Piemonte. So he has up and down Italy. I come from the other side of Italy. So together we have Italy covered. 20
yeah, it's
regions.
Beautiful.
So it's very regional.
And
yes.
People know each other there. It's amazing. Whenever I go there, people are coming over, they're saying hello, and I'm saying hello, and it's wonderful to see
it's
that.
Nice.
You know?
It's
and you're
nice.
There. I mean, you're eating dinner there a lot with friends, too. Right?
I do. My office is upstairs, so I hang around a little bit.
Yeah, which is great. That's a nice thing.
Good.
So now, listen, we're using one of your older books, Celebrate.
Oh, yes. Celebrate.
Right?
Lidia celebrates like an Italian.
Yeah.
Right, right.
It's a great one. That's one I go to a lot. That's why we're using it today.
A lot of people really enjoy it and tell me. So, yes, and the recipes you chose are very nice. This is a great salad.
A simple salad,
right? It's just carrots and orange salad. So it's a salad that you can have year-round, more or less.
Sure.
But specifically, sometimes towards the winter, you know, all the greens are so... Oranges, you know, winter is orange
No matter what.
And carrots are always good, and together it's really good and so simple to make.
Yeah.
And you know one thing about salads? Salads, sometimes when you make them, they wilt. This will keep for you.
No. I love it. And it's very fresh too, right?
Yeah.
Fresh,
very refreshing. The acidity, the sweetness of the carrots.
It
has texture, the crunchiness of the carrots. So it's good.
So we start with the oranges or the carrots?
Well, let's start with the orange.
Okay.
And let's...
I'll get
first,
going with you.
Yeah, so first, the first thing is let's peel the orange, cut. So what I do is I do like this, one side and the other, and then I just work my way around.
The smells are so fast, right? You can smell it right away, right?
Absolutely.
Now, do you make this at home, too? This is one you make, right?
Oh, absolutely. You know, this is, I find it great because that's why it's in the celebration book, because when you have you do a buffet.
Yes, yes.
And this stays on the buffet. You know, you can make it in advance. You can leave it in the refrigerator. And so make sure you get all the pith out. Okay. The white part.
This. Yep.
Yeah. Okay.
Now, you know what I'm noticing, too, with your show? Like, your grandkids are getting darn good at cooking. You know?
You know?
What is that about?
Listen, they're always hanging around. But no, when they were small, they loved it. You know, small kids, they love to get their hands into the dough, into the tomatoes, whatever.
Yeah.
Then they became kind of that puberty beginning of teenagers. They want no part of it.
Nothing really?
No, they were out with their friends. Cooking was sissy stuff or whatever
Isn't
you want to call
funny?
It.
Isn't that funny?
And now they're back into college. You know, I have three of them in college. And two of them at the end of high school. So now they're big. Now what they realize, and especially the ones in college, is that when they cook for their friends in college, they begin to be popular.
You know,
people love that.
That's a big, huge thing,
okay.
Right?
So You can throw this out.
Yeah, well, you know what, I'll scoop it right below us. How about
that? Okay. The next thing is that we're going to supreme the orange. And to supreme the orange, you see you have the wedges here. So you go just for one side and the other side, just like that. And then you keep on going around, just like that. And you get the segments. And you can do it on top of this. So we save the juice, right?
We save the juice, yeah.
So you see, it's simple. You can get, this kids can do this, no problem. Sometimes, you know, if you are too, this is, you can even make slices.
Yes, because it's sometimes very, very small here. I'm gonna do this, you know?
Yeah, yeah, sure.
I'll take the pits out.
I promise
I won't get your dress.
Okay, so that's you. So now I will go to the, while you finish that,
I'm a little slower than you, you notice?
It's okay, you talk a little bit less experience,
you know?
So, carrots. We'll just clean them.
Now, Lidia, somebody told me one time that you actually had a restaurant in Queens, too, like in the very, very early days.
I began my career in Queens. 1971, we opened our first little restaurant. It was called Bonavia, and it was on Queens Boulevard in Forest Hills.
Oh, wow.
And it was a 9-seater. It was such a small...
That's it, yeah, really? Yeah. Isn't that
such
something?
A small restaurant?
Wow!
But you know that was our beginning.
Yeah.
So yeah. But
the kids must have been very small then, right? They were babies.
Tanya wasn't even born yet.
Wow!
She was born in '72, so the year right after.
I saw that in your book, you know, because I'm going to cut this a little bit short.
Yeah, you know, Julianne.
Yeah, Julianne. So, your kids were born after that, then.
Joe was born.
Okay.
He was born in 68. And so when we opened in 71, he was 3 years old.
Oh,
and Tanya was born in 72.
Wow.
So it was...
Isn't that beautiful?
Let me tell you, I was young. I had the new restaurant. And I wasn't, you know, a real expert yet. I was young. Then I had Tanya. So it wasn't an easy beginning, but you know, we had a great time. The little restaurant, it took off, and I was not a chef, you know, right away. I wasn't a chef.
You gotta be kidding.
And so I was young, so I decided we hired an Italian American chef, and I went in the kitchen and became his sous chef.
So that's how you learn so many different things from him?
And
really?
For 10 years I stayed with him.
Wow.
And in the kitchen, then I learned, then I went to Italy. And then we enlarged, we did very well. And then we had another little restaurant in Fresh Meadows.
Really,
it was called Villa Secondo.
Oh, wow.
And
I didn't know that.
And then in 81, we sold those and opened for Lidia. And then I was kind of ready to be the chef. And that's why, you know, that's where it all started.
So, I mean, was your mom involved at all or no?
All women cooked in Italy at that time. You know, that was part of the...
Sure.
So she was, but she helped me a lot because she watched the kids.
Oh, sure, that's great.
But she helped me make the pasta, the gnocchis, and all of that. She would come in the morning. So, yeah, it was a family affair.
And, of course, we love her on the show. I mean, I'm not speaking just for me. You know, the night that my mom passed away, we were having our Lidia... We call it the Lidia dinner. It's a Becco dinner for people who pledge to our telethon. And Lidia called me. She said, you know, you don't have to come. She said, you know, we're praying for you, and we'll take care of it for you tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And my dad said, listen, there's no place you should be tonight but then at Becco. He said, so I'm going to go to bed early. I'm tired. And why don't you go? It's just me and my dad. He said, why don't you go? And so that's where I spent that night. And it was like being with family. You know, I never forgot that. It was the most beautiful night for me, you know.
But he was right, because these are the people that love you, that follow you.
Yeah, nice.
And, you know, that's who you need next to you in times of grieving.
When it's not so good, things are tough, you know.
Okay.
And sometimes people say, you know, well, you're a priest. Like, how could it be that difficult? But a mom is a mom, right, you know? There's never enough time.
We're human, too.
Yeah, right.
You're human, too, are you?
I think so. It's fleshy. If you cut it, it bleeds.
Okay.
Look, I got burned making toast the other day.
Oh, okay. All right. So what do you think?
That
should we
beautiful.
Do some more carrots? Oh, it's enough.
I like it. I think it looks great.
I think it's enough.
Now, you call for some olives in here, too.
Absolutely.
So why don't we talk about olives for a minute? So, like,
yeah,
what's the story with olives? I mean, there's so many different kinds, right?
Absolutely. You know, there's 1,200 different olive trees. You know, which olives do you make olive oil from? And they're all different places in the world, different varietals grow better. But olives are all green until they mature.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
My hands are slippery. Okay. I was praying that you would be able to do that. I don't think I can do it.
All right, let me see.
We can drain them if you want, right?
Yeah, I'm going to. You want to drain them? Let's do it this way. Let's do it backwards.
Yeah, now that, look at that. Like, that's a very red brine, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. What do you think?
Mm, nice.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
So now these are pitted. They have pits. They're not pitted. You can put the pits in there, but that's sometimes dangerous.
Sure, sure.
You can tell your guests, you know.
Right, be careful.
Yeah. Be careful. Or you can just smash them like that, and you pull out the pit. Go ahead.
I'll pull out the pits.
Just pull out the pits.
Oh, yeah, they come right out. Look at that. That's easy, huh?
Yeah.
Wow. Actually, you don't want to have to pay the dental bills, right? So that's good.
Well, you know, you could bite into it, accidentally, and there it is.
Then you got trouble.
This is the Gaeta olives.
Gaeta,
you know,
right?
Gaeta is a town near Naples, between Naples and Rome.
Uh-huh.
And these little black olives there are delicious. They're delicious. They make oil out of them, but they're even better to be cured. Sometimes they're cured in a brine. Sometimes they're kind of dry cured.
You really, know, yeah?
With salt. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Have you ever been to Gaeta?
I have never been there. Now, you know, I rarely get outside of Rome. I got to start traveling around a little bit in Italy,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you go down, a drive from Rome to Naples is beautiful. Then you can go down to Sorrento and so on. Mm.
Now, how often do you get over? Once a year, probably, right? Twice a year?
Even more.
Even more?
Good. So you see, you throw it just like this. It's so easy.
This is not so hard at all, right?
You see, the kids can do that.
And it's a great thing to teach the kids. Whoops, I just threw the pin in. That's no good. To learn, to teach our kids about this and learn about the cuisine. And that's what you've done with your grandkids. I mean, they really know this stuff now because you've taught them their whole lives, really, about this.
Well, their whole lives, you know. And we have a little garden at home with grandma. But when we traveled through Italy, you know, going to the farms, they used to come with us, you know.
Yeah, that's great.
And they still, then again, a little bit in between. Now they go to school. But they loved coming with us and meeting the farmers, the cheesemakers. So, you know, they would talk a little bit and then they would take off. You know, they go play with the animals.
Of course, yeah. You know what I also love, though? I do love the fact that faith is a big part of it all, Lidia, you know? And for you and your family, really, faith is right there, you know? It's so nice to see.
There's that kind of basic element that gives you peace, that ties you. It's the family, it's the table, it's faith. And that gives you security.
Yeah.
That gives you, and then you're ready to kind of go out and face the world.
Whatever it is.
Yeah.
Right? Whatever it is.
Yeah, you take
say,
it, right? Whatever it is. So now the dressing.
Yes, now we have olive oil there. And there's some white wine vinegar, I believe, right?
Just a little bit. So let's.
Now, to give us a little lesson in olive oil, because it's so confusing now. And you could get olive oil, it's like $50 or $60 a bottle. And then you get olive oil, it's like $3 a bottle, right?
Yes. Now. Are you going to, or
are we having a problem? Let's see if there's
Got it. I got it.
Thank you, St. Anthony. That was a gift.
A little bit of vinegar. So as I told you, a little bit of salt. Now the olives are, you know, you always, when you do that, you think
salt.
About
yeah.
They're already salt. So just a little bit like that. Okay. A little pepper.
That looks nice though, huh?
Yes. So you see, this is how simple this is.
I love it. It's beautiful.
No.
I'm going to get a little green, you know. I bought the leftover Italian parsley from my garden.
You know
sort
what?
Of the very near the end.
I wash my hands. Do you don't mind? Do you?
That's the best thing God gave you is your hands, right?
This is the best tools. The best tools in the kitchen.
I agree with you. I use it
just,
all the time.
You know.
Let me do this. I get a little
clean
parsley.
Them up. So look nice. Look how this, how nice this looks.
Look how beautiful it looks, right?
Okay, and this is for you and I. We'll share it
a
together.
A little something to share, right?
Mm-hmm.
You want me to put a little parsley or you have an idea?
Sure. No, put it.
I'm going to put a little
here. We're in it together.
To sink or swim, right?
Yeah. So I would put a little more of this. What do you think?
I love that. I could drink that right out of a cup right now. Either way.
Here. This is for us.
Yeah, this is for your hand. Because.
Yeah, thank you.
This is like serving mass with the priest. They give you the towel. This way you can wash your hands.
So there you go.
Look how beautiful
we're,
that
we're
is,
busy
right?
Talking and all that. And it looks beautiful. You can present it. Looks refreshing. I'm going to put it right here.
Incredibly unique, right?
Yes. You know, one would not think of And it's not, you know, it's something that's especially in the winter. It's not expensive, carrots, and it's healthy for you.
Absolutely not.
Now,
beautiful.
Get your fork.
I have my fork here.
And I'm going to get my fork.
I want a little, I love the olives so much.
Yeah, the olive, one of each.
Yeah, that's how you have to do it, right?
Oh, where's the oh
we did my. Such a good job with the carrots. They're small. There we go.
Mmm.
Mmm. Delicious, right? So fresh.
Mmm. It's fresh, refreshing, at the same time, kind of meaty and complex, the olives.
Nice.
Maybe so it's beautiful.
Crusty bread, too, would be the other thing, huh?
Absolutely.
With everything crusty bread. I could do that with Cheerios.
Yeah, I know.
Delicious, though, right?
Yeah. Easy, juicy. The pits, let's put the pits out.
That might have been me again. You know me.
Are you at it
I'm
again?
The pit and then throw away the meat. I know. All right, we're going to take a little break. When we get back, another great recipe with Lidia Bastianich. Stick around.
The Catholic Faith Network Green Room was provided by Lane Office, your workspace built with integrity.
Lidia, we're going to do a great one now. When I think about my childhood, this was one of the basics that we had all the time, Fridays and Lent. You know, this was something we always had.
I mean, you can go on a little pasta, oil, garlic, and a little bit of anchovies and a little hot pepper. And, you know, cheese was expensive.
Yeah, you're right.
Toasted breadcrumbs.
Yeah, I see that you have them here.
Yeah, took the place of cheese. That was the poor man's cheese.
Isn't that amazing?
So you know what? The time that it takes for the pasta to cook, we will have the sauce done.
All right, well, I'm going to get going on some bowl.
So stop chopping that garlic, slicing it.
You just want it sliced, right?
Yeah, I like slices.
Now, it's funny thing about garlic, Lidia, like in some recipes now, they have you smash it and take it out.
Well, I do that too. You know, garlic, the more you cut it, the more, let's see, this is, I think, I'm looking how much is enough for you and for me.
You know, I don't think there's enough in that bag for you and me, but that's a different story.
No, I think it's enough.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I think that's enough. I think that's
I'm
enough.
Thinking the Becca way, all you want. You can eat, can't eat any more.
All right. You know, garlic, because once, the more you cut it, the more the flavor comes out. Okay, you can throw that in here for me.
Okay, you ready for me?
Yeah.
Let me just get this through.
I will.
Okay. Get ready. A little sizzle noise, I think.
Uh-huh.
This is wonderful. Now, because you have this new cookbook. Now, this cookbook is kind of going back, which is nice. But when you're doing a cookbook like this, I mean, do you kind of test a lot of this out or stuff you're already doing?
Oh, absolutely. We test every time.
You do?
Yeah, everything. Now, you know, I haven't invented any recipes. All these recipes have been there for centuries. It's part of the Italian heritage. But, you know, we modify it. We all do our own little thing to it.
Well, I was thinking of that. Like, this recipe, you know, wouldn't be fair to put a little shrimp in there, to be honest with you, right?
There you go. Just make sure the shrimps cook very quickly towards the end.
Get it all ready.
But you can, vegetables, you can do it with vegetables, so even chicken breast. Okay, so you can put in, let me raise this a little bit, anchovies.
Now, I'm a fan of anchovies. Sometimes people look and they say, oh, anchovies, I don't know, Monsignor. But these are delicious and they add a lot to everything, right?
Yeah, and you can throw them whole. Like, you can chop them up, but throw them right in.
Put them in their whole because don't you think they'll just break down?
They'll disintegrate, absolutely. And the anchovy is like the umami, if you will, one of the umamis of the Italian cuisine. Certainly in making pasta and sauces, but I even use it in roasts.
Isn't that great?
Chop it up a little bit.
That's interesting.
Yeah. And in roasts.
Well, people shouldn't be afraid of this flavor, right? I mean, it's wonderful.
Absolutely not. They're afraid of this fishy. The only thing that you have to keep in consideration, you see, it's breaking up already.
Yes, it breaks up fast, right?
The only thing that you keep in consideration is the salt. The anchovies have salt.
Lots of salt.
Yes, so, you know, putting in the water, not too much salt. And another thing I think that we have to make a little peperoncino.
Yeah, I love that. Do you mind if I do the pinch?
You go right ahead.
Here we go. Look at this. With Lidia, I'm putting the peperoncino in. That's pretty good.
Yeah, and this is kind of toasting it now, and you get that extra flavor.
I love that, too.
But for cooking pasta, you know, a lot of people want to put salt. Yes. You know, you got to put a little bit. If you wash your salt, you can diminish it, you know, put a little bit. Right. Pasta, if you cook it in plain water, it's flat.
It really is. That's the truth. Okay. You're absolutely right.
So here, you see all the anchovies are breaking down. I'm going to taste.
Now you put Now you're making the sauce, literally.
Right, from the pasta water.
Looks beautiful.
Okay.
I love that.
So that's going to cook away, and...
And somehow, this gets sticky. It gets thicker. It's amazing, right?
Yeah, it emulsifies, if you will.
I got to get some parsley. I'm sitting here looking at you.
Yeah.
We got to do some parsley, too, right?
Okay, chop some parsley. Let's see.
I love parsley, too, right?
You know parsley is very good for you, very healthy.
Is it really?
Yeah. It has a lot of vitamins, a lot of minerals.
This year I made parsley pesto, too,
Delicious. When I make pesto, I always put basil and parsley.
Both, huh?
Uh-huh.
I never did that. That's a great idea, though.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, that's
because
a great
sometimes,
idea.
Sometimes basil can be just too much, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it is a lot. You're right.
Uh-huh. And you don't rinse the pasta. You can drain the pasta, but you don't rinse the pasta.
And again, you don't cook like that.
No.
Just a minute, if you can, with me on olive oil, too, because we have extra virgin.
So I'm looking at this, and this is al dente. A bit al dente. I'm
going to
put
it. Believe it or not.
I'm going to put it right in here, and I'm going to let it cook in here, so it's going to get the flavor
so
of the sauce.
In there, right?
Yeah, it's going to finish in there and get the flavor. Okay, right. Look at this. This looks good.
You ready for a little of this?
I am ready for a little bit of that.
Okay.
I'm just a little bit. I want to dress it a little bit of oil.
A little fresh oil there. Right?
Yeah, and I'm looking at this.
Looks beautiful though, right?
Doesn't it look nice?
Ah, it looks so
and
nice.
And you see how simple?
Beautiful how that turned out.
Simple. Now, if you're cooking like this and it's not done completely, you have your water and just a little bit of water.
You can adjust, right?
Yes. And always save a little bit of the water.
Let me bring this over for you.
Yeah, let's.
Because this looks like it's
going to clean up here.
I'll clean up a little bit.
Okay.
While you're working. I'm so happy that you don't mind doing this work, because I was worried I'd have to do all of this cooking, and I'm like, thank God she's doing this. This is wonderful.
No, I love it. And
look how nice
love
that
sharing,
looks, though, right?
Talking. Huh?
It just looks so beautiful. It looks terrific.
Isn't it?
Ah, oh. Can't get over how nice
and
it looks.
And you know the smell? There's a little plate for you and me in someplace.
God, I thought you'd never say that part of it. There you go. Let me see if I can find a little something.
Yeah, just let's white. Clean it up a little bit. And then you have the breadcrumbs there, which I toasted beforehand. And that's a great way of using leftover bread that you have.
So what you do is put it in a food processor and then toast it off, right?
Yeah, coarsely, and then just a little bit of oil in a pan, and you toast
it. And you called it poor man's cheese, right?
Yeah, exactly.
That was the story?
Exactly. That's what, okay. So, a little bit like that.
Look how nice that looks. It's beautiful.
Yeah. And do a little bit like that you did before. Just
make a little bouquet?
A little bouquet.
Okay.
To decorate this one.
I feel like I'm one of your grandkids. Ha! You're working with me here. You're helping me push in.
Love it. Okay. So this is, look. This
beautiful,
two
right?
beautiful plates.
Two beautiful people and one. Two beautiful people, two beautiful plates. What
That's
do you
think? That's right. And delicious plates.
This I've never used.
And this is it.
We're in the family of food. We all share, right?
Absolutely.
This is how it works.
The same. You know, my grandmother used to have a big, they called it a bowl.
Uh-huh.
And usually the pasta was all put in the bowl. And we all sat around the table.
Eat together, right?
And yeah. And you took it on your plate.
You know, my grandmother used to...
But sometimes somebody would go right in there.
My grandmother used to pour the polenta right on the wooden board on the table. We all ate right off the polenta.
Sure. Okay.
Here we go.
Salute.
Salute.
Chin chin.
Mmm. I can't even tell you. That's absolutely fabulous. Nothing on you, nothing on me.
I have a little paper. I feel.
Are you choked up or no? You're all right? Good.
I think the little pepper you got stuck together. I got it.
I like the pepper. Very good though, right?
I love pepperoncino, so this is it. As simple as that.
Beautiful dish. When we come back, we'll say a little prayer with Lidia. We'll ask the Lord to bless her family, your family, my family too. We'll be right back.
Okay.
This was a great day. Thank you so much for being here. We're so glad you came, Lidia.
My pleasure.
I love you. Thank
Always
you so
a
much.
Pleasure being with you.
Thank you so much.
Good food, good, simple, honest food.
That's what I love.
For
That's
families.
That's what you stand for, faith, food, family. I read it in your book.
That's right.
Talk about that memoir 1 second, because that's beautiful too, your story.
Yeah, my memoir, Lidia's My American Dream.
Yeah.
And it's about my life, you know, I'm an immigrant, and how apropos it is in today's world. And I was given an opportunity. My family were given an opportunity by the Catholic Charities that brought us here. And they made our lives. Our lives are because I am who I am. I achieved because I was given an opportunity to be here, to be free, to be able to practice my faith. And I'm forever grateful.
We are too. Believe me, we're glad you're here.
Thank you.
Now, the new book is going to be called...
For Lidia,
which is that beautiful restaurant in the city. A lot of you have been there. It's a great special occasion restaurant, too. A great everyday restaurant, but special occasions in particular. I love it for that.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, it's a great restaurant for that. So you'll be all over the place with that book. And if they want to learn more, they could go to your website, right?
Absolutely. Lidiasitaly.com.
And that's where you can see what's going on. And we're already scheming during the commercial break, a couple of things for you and I to do together, right?
Absolutely. We'll keep them posted.
Yeah, we'll keep you informed. Don't worry about that. Before we leave, let's ask the Lord to bless all of our families. So let us pray. Loving God, you are the source of all good in our lives, and we ask you to bless all of our family members, the people we love so much. Keep them close to us always and keep them safe, Lord, and help them to know that they are loved and cared for. Keep us close to you, Lord, that we may serve you with our lives and bless our families this day through Christ our Lord. Amen. God bless everybody. We'll see you next time.
Ciao.
On Real Food.
Real Food Set and Appliances has been provided by Chufo Cabinetry, a family tradition of fine woodworking since 1907. Chufo Cabinetry has been filling the custom cabinetry needs of the New York tri-state area for over 100 years by combining old world techniques with modern technology to provide the finest custom kitchens and millwork. Luxury appliance innovators, Sub-Zero, Wolf, and Cove. Cosentino, a Spanish company world leader in the production and distribution of innovative surfaces for architecture and design. Silestone, Decton, and Sensa by Cosentino, technologically advanced surfaces that allow the creation of unique designs for the home and public spaces. Blackman Plumbing Supply. Visit a Blackman showroom today and let their specially trained design consultants help you find the luxury plumbing, tile, lighting, and stone products you need to make your project a success. Top Knobs, the designer's choice.